Hello, welcome to Puerto Rico Legal Video Blog. My name is Santiago Lampón, and I am a lawyer and a notary in Puerto Rico. In this video, I cover the subject of adverse possession as to one particular item that just presented, was presented to me in a case that I'm handling here in Puerto Rico. And it has to do with the word possession. It may seem obvious, you know, adverse possession is the term normally used across English-speaking countries. In Puerto Rico, we have different language, not only because it's Spanish, okay? But the words are kind of like complex, so translation into English is a little bit tricky. So that's why I just use adverse possession. But the word possession is very important. In this situation that was presented to me this week, not a client, but someone else said, well, you know what? I've been in possession of the property up to here, meaning like the property line, okay? But, you know, there was a drawing done many years ago that shows that the property line was actually here. So apparently my neighbor encroached. Wait a minute, sir. Do you have a title register at the property registration? No, I don't. That's why I'm looking at adverse possession. He says, well, have you been in possession of that sliver of land, of that additional piece of land? He says, well, no, but the property map shows. He says, no, sir, wait. But in this case, he was a gentleman. He says, adverse possession requires possession, that you actually hold. Not that you're there every day, every month, every week, every year, but that you hold the property as an owner and that you care and use the property as an owner. If not, it is not possession. So, you know, that there is a map that shows additional land or whatever. Yes, I look at maps, I look at drawings, I look at surveys, and I definitely study the history of possession. But whenever that neighbor built upon your land, that neighbor became in possession of the property and you stop having possession of the property. That's the way it is. Okay? So look at this aspect of possession as owners. And there are other requirements and things to consider, but I wanted to give you at least this little brief of information because that's the purpose of this blog, to give you some information that makes it easier for you to understand Puerto Rico law. And again, my name is Santiago Lampón, a lawyer and a notary in Puerto Rico, and you have just watched a video at Puerto Rico Legal Video Blog. Thank you for watching.